Are you ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
Hey everybody, my name is Miss Jenny and welcome to Genesis Boyne Kids. What are you doing, Mr. Kerfuffle?
Well, I was looking at you.
Uh-huh.
And then I was looking at the camera.
I see.
Hey kids!
You're just being silly, aren't you?
Well, I had a lot of candy last night.
Oh, did you? Why was that?
Well, because last night was Halloween.
Oh, what'd you do for Halloween?
Well, I'll tell you. I went out and I got some candy and I was like, I ate a bunch of candy.
Oh.
And then I went to a Halloween party.
Did you?
Yeah.
What did you go as?
Well, I went as a dolphin.
A dolphin.
Yeah.
How was that?
Well, it was a really cool party. Mm-hmm. And I met a whale while I was at the party. And really, we just clicked.
Did you?
Yeah, it was a whale joke because, you know, whales and dolphins, they click.
Oh, they do, right? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, see, yeah.
Right. No, mostly dolphins click.
That was a marine biologist joke.
Right.
Anyway, so after that, we went to the movies and we watched The Humpback of Notre Dame.
That's not a whale.
The Humpback of Notre Dame?
No.
The Humpback Whale. Come on, people, work with me here.
Hunchback. But
oh, right.
Speaking of whales, that reminds me of our story today.
Oh, by the way, I used to know some killer whale jokes, but I've forgotten them all.
I see. That's just, you're on a roll today, aren't you?
I'm on a roll, like, woo!
Anyway.
Candy!
Our story today is about Jonah again. Mm-hmm. So do you remember what happened to Jonah last week?
Well, I remember Jonah was a prophet of God.
Mm-hmm, he was.
And God told Jonah, go to Nineveh.
And then what happened?
Well, I can't quite remember, but I suppose since Jonah was a prophet of God, like Isaiah and Elijah and Daniel, and God, prophets were always people who listened to God, I suppose Jonah listened to God and went to Nineveh just like God told him.
That's not what happened.
What?
No, that's not what happened.
What type of prophet is this guy?
A disobedient prophet is.
Apparently.
So do you remember what actually happened where he went instead of Nineveh?
Oh, yeah. He went out in a boot.
Out in a boat.
I thought he went out in a boot.
No, out in a boat.
Okay, so this is not a Canadian story.
No, it's about a boat that he got into.
Okay, yeah, I got
it. Do you remember what happened after he got into the boat?
Yeah, no, I remember that. A storm came, but everyone was out fishing because they were casting a lot, and somehow they caught Jonah when they were casting.
No.
No?
No.
No?
No.
What was it?
Well, the storm came, and Jonah was in the bottom of the boat sleeping, and the sailors didn't know what was happening because it was such a bad storm, and so they tried to figure out what happened.
Okay.
And they figured out that God was mad at Jonah
for
going
that?
The wrong way because they cast lots.
Oh,
yep.
I thought they were casting a lot like because they were fishermen.
Nope. It's a thing to try and figure out stuff that they used to do.
Okay, yeah, that makes more sense.
They cast lots and found out that Jonah was being disobedient. And so they reluctantly had to throw Jonah overboard. Into the sea.
Under the sea?
Into the sea.
Okay, into the sea.
Right.
And that's the story of Jonah.
Well, that's the story of Jonah up to the point where he got thrown into the sea.
Okay, well, I feel like I've got the gist of it by now.
Pretty close.
Okay, good.
So, anyway, let's summarize the story one more time so we're sure that
we know what it is. Okay, yeah, mm-hmm. So we don't want any of the kids to get confused. Kids, don't get confused. Sometimes
right.
I get a little bit confused and I'm just like, what is going on here? But just to summarize, there was a prophet. His name was Jonah.
Mm-hmm.
God asked Jonah to go to Nineveh.
Mm-hmm.
But Jonah didn't follow God. Instead, he went the other way.
Mm-hmm.
He went out in a boat, not out in a boot. Mm-hmm. And a storm came and everyone wasn't casting a lot. They were casting lots. And the lot said that it was Jonah. So they threw Jonah overboard.
Mm-hmm.
where he was eaten by a whale.
That's true. That is the last thing that happened last week. So that gets us to our story this week. And since it's story time, that means, could you go get Jonah for us?
I'll go get Jonah. Hey,
all Jonah. Right. Hey, Jonah. Hey, Jonah. Hey, Jonah.
And I will get the whale because the story today is called Jonah and the Whale, which comes from Jonah chapter 2. So we're going to start where Jonah had just been thrown overboard. He's sitting in the water. He's floating there.
Well, this is really awkward. I guess I'm going to have to swim back home.
But then all of a sudden, a giant fish came.
Oh, holy moly, wow!
And ate Jonah and swallowed him right up. And now, I don't know if you've ever been swallowed by a whale before, but I would guess that it is pretty dark inside of a whale. And do you remember how we'd said that God had told Jonah to go to Nineveh, and Jonah had said no? Well, while Jonah was inside the whale, Jonah began to think about how he had disobeyed God. So Jonah began to pray.
Dear God, I need to talk to you. As you know, I'm stuck here in the bottom of the ocean. I'm so far deep under the sea in the belly of this whale, and God, I'm in trouble. I made a huge blunder. I didn't follow you when you told me something to do. I acted like a dunderhead. Let's just be honest here. Because I thought my ideas were better than your ideas. So God, can you please help me to listen to you better? Please take care of me, God. Amen.
And that night, while sitting in the whale, it was silent and it was dark. And then on the second day in the belly of the whale, Jonah prayed to God some more.
Okay. Dear God, the waters are closing in on me here. It's getting real tough. I know that you can snatch me from the jaws of death, though. You're awesome. God, I'll do whatever you say. I'll follow you when you tell me to. I'll do what I do. I promise. I want to tell you how great and how awesome you are, God. God, you know everything, and I was foolish for not listening to you. So I'm just real sorry. Amen.
And then on the second night, it was still silent and dark. And then on the third day in the belly of the whale, Jonah prayed to God one more time.
Okay, I can do this. Dear God, I'm falling apart here. I'm not going to lose hope, though, because I know I can always come to you when I'm in trouble. Like right now, I'm in wicked trouble. I'm still in the belly of this whale. And God, I pray that you will save me. You let me do what you asked me to do. I'll never say no, can't do again. I'll say, you got it, boss. So just let me go and preach to those Ninevite jokers. I'll sing super hard every Sunday. I'll do all the things you asked me to do, I promise. God, I know I can be saved by your great and mighty power. God, please just save me. Amen.
And after the third day of praying while in the whale, God told the whale to go throw Jonah back up on the beach. And so the whale did.
Oh my, I'm back. I'm not in the ocean anymore. I'm not in a whale. I'm on a beach. I'm alive. I'm okay. Ah, thank goodness.
Jonah.
Yes, God.
Jonah, I want you to get up off this beach and go to the city of Nineveh. When you get there, tell them that they have not been following me.
Huh? You got it, boss. I'm going right away. I'm on it. See you later, kids. I'm on it. I'm going to Nineveh.
And Jonah hopped right up and began to walk to Nineveh. And he was happy to follow God and to preach the message that God had given him. The end. Isn't that an amazing story? Can you even imagine being swallowed up by a whale? I know I can't. And I bet it was pretty scary when that happened. But God did a good job of getting Jonah to listen to him. And now Jonah's all ready to go and preach his message to the people of Nineveh. Mm. And then we'll find out next week what happens in our conclusion of the story of Jonah.
You know, Jonah seems pretty upset about being in that whale.
I mean, can't you blame him?
Yeah, but I mean, I still, like, after 3 days, I was like, Jonah, what are you blubbering about?
You are just full of whale jokes, aren't you?
Yeah, I mean, of course, part of Jonah's problem was he was spouting off to God in the first place.
You just can't stop.
And Jonah breached his agreement with God, which never goes well.
Do you have any more of that?
I suppose I don't, because I shouldn't keep harpooning on Jonah.
Uh-huh. Any more whale puns?
No, I suppose, as the French say, I am thin.
Do whales have fins? I mean, I guess they do.
How do you think fins. They get around? I think you had a whale on your fin on your whale.
The fin. Yep, it's a fin.
Yep, it's a fin. It's a
fin.
Fin!
So we learned something today.
Yes, we learned that if a deaf person is missing a finger, then they have a speech impediment.
We did not learn that.
But it's true.
I guess it is. Is that like a lisp for deaf people?
I suppose so.
And not what we learned.
Oh, okay. What did we learn?
We learned that it is a good idea to listen to God the first time. It's gonna save a lot of time and a lot of heartache, and it's gonna make your life so much better.
That is so true. Because if God tells you to do something, kids, do not think, you know, I have a better idea. Because if that's what you think, you probably need to rethink your life choices.
That is true. Because when you're not following what God wants and you're following what you want, it tends to turn out bad.
That is so true. And it's probably because we don't actually know better than God.
We really do not know better than God. We just kind of think we do sometimes.
Mm-hmm. And by sometimes, you mean pretty much all the time.
Right. But in the end, God knows better.
Yes.
So kids, let's all pray together that God will tell us what to do and that we'll follow him when we hear what to do in everything that we do.
All right.
So let's close your eyes and bow your heads. Lord, thank you that we can talk to you. Thank you that you can tell us what you want from us, Lord. Help us to follow you the first time. Help us to hear what you want and to joyfully do what it is that you want. You are so good and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
So to conclude, remember that in the description below, there is a link to a lesson on Jonah that you can do with your kids. It has verses and questions and activity and a prayer so they can help. You can help build on the story that we learned today. There's also a link to a playlist that you can watch all of the Genesis Point Kids worship videos right here on the screen. So we'll see you guys next week on Genesis Point Kids.
Bye, guys.
Bye.